We have to be mindful of the words that we speak. We have to be mindful of the company we keep. We have to be mindful of the things that we ingest, we take into our minds, bazalwane. Be mindful on a daily basis. Let's not live wasteful lives, bazalwane. We apologize for the cutting of this video, but when the network is doing things. But we will continue to preach in the mighty name of Jesus. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 6, even as we come to the end of today's message, Bangwele, like we said, that we will be speaking in three different parts, Bangwele. And so tomorrow we'll be looking for the next verse. So verse 6 says, let no one delude and deceive you with empty excuses and groundless arguments for these sins. For through these things, the wrath of God comes upon the sons of rebellion and disobedience. Let no one delude and deceive you with empty excuses and groundless arguments for these sins. Let no one lie to you. We must not let anyone lie to us. You live once. You must enjoy. You must enjoy what life is enjoyable. And the effects of it. Think of the effects of it. Let's just take sexual immorality. Every person that you come together with sexually, you get married. You become one. Your spirit and the person's spirit become one. How many times do you want to get married? Who's born no matter how sweet she is, a relationship? That's Uhamba now. It is true. Because they are still inside you. There are repercussions for actions, Bazalwane. Consequences for actions. The words that you speak. If you speak poverty, if you speak ill of other people, do you think that thing will not affect you? If you act negatively, we do sometimes in prison ministry. People tell their stories that some people that have even murdered other people. Other people say they cannot sleep because they are tormented by the spirit of this person. Whether they are saved or they are not saved. Everyone belongs to God. They are created and they are made in the image of God. All of those things, Bazalwane, don't let people fool you with empty excuses and groundless arguments for these sins. So through this thing, the wrath of God comes upon the sons of rebellion and disobedience. I do not want to see the wrath of God. We do not want to see the wrath of God because of disobedience. Let's just be obedient to the word of God. Let's just do what God tells us to do. Let's just walk according to his Holy Spirit. Let's just do the word of God. Let's just say yes to his leading, Bangwele. We do not want to see the wrath of God because we refuse to go and do the will of God. We are reminded in the old covenant. Yes, Bazalwane, funeke sikhumbule ukuthi the same God who is in the old covenant is the same God in the new covenant. And grace was there also in the old covenant. I'm reminded when God wanted to destroy the children of Israel when they were complaining, and Moses went and prayed for Israel. God's wrath subsided, which means the grace of God was there as well in the beginning. The grace that we speak of in the new covenant was there, but the wrath of God was also there, which means the wrath of God is still here as well. The wrath of God that saw God opening up the ground and swallowing people that were disobedient to him. It is the same wrath of God that we can see namhlanje. It is possible. So let's not be disobedient versus full upon the wrath of God. As women, ngamabonzi manje sivume nje ukwenza intando kaNkulunkulu, sivumele nje ukwenza intando yakhe, sihambe according to his will, bangcwele. So do not associate OP sharers with them. Do not associate OP sharers with these things. Do not associate with evil. Do not associate with sin. Do not associate with the kingdom of darkness. Do not associate with greed. Do not associate with envy, with covetousness. Do not associate with sexual immorality. Do not associate with speaking evil words. Do not associate with negative things. But choose to do the will of God. Choose to be an imitator of Jesus Christ. Choose to imitate Christ. Choose to imitate God. Choose to be like Christ. Choose to think like Christ. Choose to speak like Christ. Choose to be a child of God that listens and does the will of God. We must choose to be children of God that do the will of God at all times, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Be blessed, Bangwele, and let us meet again, even as we continue to read and understand the book of Ephesians, chapter number 5. We praise the Lord for teaching us in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.